Shalom. Blessings to you in the name of Jesus, Messiah of the world. This is Miriam, your faithful black sheep. Welcome, sheep in the garden. Today is the 25th of July, 2020 on the Gregorian calendar. However, it is the 5th of August on God's dark new moon calendar. And so I thought, you know, let's find a scripture on the 5th of July. So here we are in Ezekiel chapter 8. If you would like to join me, we'll be reading through chapter 10. And it came to pass in the sixth year, in the sixth month, on the fifth day of the month, as I sat in my house, and the elders of Judah sat before me, that the hand of Adonai, Yahuwah, fell there upon me. Then I beheld, and lo, a likeness as the appearance of fire, from the appearance of his loins even downward, fire, and from his loins even upward as the appearance of brightness, as the color of amber. And he put forth the form of a hand, and took me by a lock of my head, and the ruach, that is the spirit, lifted me up between the earth and the heavens, and brought me in the visions of Elohim to Jerusalem. Ah, it's going to rain! Come on, let's go over here. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Okay. All right. Oopsie. It started raining. Okay, let's start from verse 2. And then I beheld, and lo, a likeness as the appearance of fire, from the appearance of his loins even downward, fire, and from his loins even upward. Let the dogs in, please. From his loins even upward, as the appearance of the brightness, as the color of amber. And he put forth the form of a hand, and took me up by a lock of my head. And the Spirit lifted me up between the earth and the heavens, and brought me into the visions of Elohim, to Jerusalem, to the door of the inner gate that looks toward the north, where was the seat of the image of jealousy, which provoked to jealousy. And behold, the glory of Elohai of Israel was there, according to the vision that I saw in the plain. And then he said unto me, Son of Adam, lift up your eyes now the way toward the north. Which way? Toward the north. And so I lifted up my eyes the way toward the north, and I beheld northward at the gate of the altar this image of jealousy in the entry. And he said furthermore unto me, Son of Adam, see you what they do? Even the great abominations that the house of Israel commits here, that I should go far off from my sanctuary? But turn yet again, and you shall see greater abominations. And he brought me to the door of the court, and when I looked, behold, a hole in the wall. And then he said unto me, Son of Adam, dig now in the wall. And when I had dug in the wall, behold, a door. And he said unto me, Go in, and behold the wicked abominations that they do here. And so I went in and saw, and behold, every form of creeping things and abominable beasts and all the idols of the house of Israel portrayed upon the wall round about. And there stood before them 70 men of the ancients of the house of Israel. And in the midst of them stood Yazanyahu, the son of Shaphan, and every man his censer in his hand, and a thick cloud of incense went up. And then he said unto me, Son of Adam, have you seen what the ancients of the house of Israel do in the dark? Every man in the chambers of his imagery, for they say, Yahuwah sees us not. Yahuwah has forsaken Alpha and Omega divine, the earth. And he said unto me also, Turn yet again, and you shall see greater abominations than they do. And then he brought me to the door of the gate of Yahuwah's house, which was toward the north. And behold, there sat women weeping for Tammuz. And then he said unto me, Have you seen this, O son of Adam? Turn yet again, and you shall see greater abominations than these. And he brought me into the inner court of Yahuwah's house. And behold, at the door of the temple of Yahuwah, between the porch and the altar, were about 25 men with their backs toward the temple of Yahuwah, and their faces toward the east. And they worshiped the sun toward the east. They worshiped the sun toward the east. And then he said unto me, Have you seen this, O son of Adam? Is it a light thing to the house of Judah that they commit the abominations which they commit here? For they have filled Aleph and Tav, divine the land, with violence, and have returned to provoke me to anger. And lo, they put Aleph and Tav, divine the branch, to their nose. Therefore will I also deal in fury. My eye shall not spare, neither will I have pity. And though they cry in my ears and with a loud voice, yet will I not hear them. And he cried also in my ears with a loud voice, saying, Cause them that have charge over the city to draw near, upon every man with his destroying weapon in his hand. And behold, 6 came from the way of the higher gate, which lies toward the north, and every man a slaughter weapon in his hand. And one man among them was clothed with linen, and with a writer's inkhorn by his side. And they went in and stood beside the brazen altar. And the glory of the Elohai of Israel was gone up from the cherub, whereupon he was, to the threshold of the house. And he called to the man clothed with linen, which had the writer's inkhorn by his side. And Yahuwah said unto him, Go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a tav upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof. And what does it say in Revelation? That he is going around and sealing his children. And to the others, verse 5, I'm in chapter 8 now, 9 now. And to the others, he said in my hearing, Go ye after him through the city and smite, and let not your eye spare, neither have you pity. Slay utterly, old and young, both maids and little children and women, but come not near upon any man who has the tav, and begin at my sanctuary. And what is the tav? It is the sign of the cross. It is the ancient Hebrew symbol for the cross. And the tav is omega. The, you know, Aleph and Tav, the first and the last, the beginning and the ending, right? And these begin at my, he tells them to begin at his sanctuary. And then they began at the ancient men which were before the house. And he said unto them, Defile Aleph and Tav, divine the house, and fill Aleph and Tav, divine the courts with the slain. Go ye forth. And they went forth and slew in the city. And it came to pass, while they were slaying them, and I was left, that I fell upon my face and cried and said, Adonai Yahuwah, will you destroy all the remnant of Israel in your pouring out of Aleph and Tav, divine your fury upon Jerusalem? Then he said unto me, The iniquity of the house of Israel and Judah is exceedingly great, and the land is full of blood, and the city full of perverseness. For they say, Yahuwah has forsaken Aleph and Tav, divine the earth, and Yahuwah sees not. And as for me also, my eye shall not spare, neither will I have pity, but I will recompense their way upon their head. And behold, the man clothed with linen, which had the inkhorn by his side, reported the matter, saying, I have done as you have commanded me. Chapter 10. This is talking about Ophanims and Seraphim. Here we go. And then I looked, and behold, in the expanse. What is the expanse? That is the heavens that was above the head of the cherubim. There appeared over them, as it were, a sapphire stone, and as the appearance of the likeness of a throne. And that's a direct, again, a reference to Revelation. And he spoke unto the man clothed with linen and said, Go in between the wheels. Go in between the UFOs. Go in between the wheels, even under the cherub, and fill your hand with coals of fire from between the cherubim and scatter them over the city. This is fire raining down as hail. And he went in my sight. Now, the cherubim stood on the right side of the house when the man went in, and the cloud filled Aleph and Tav, the inner court. And the glory of Yahuwah went up from the cherub and stood over the threshold of the house. And the house was filled, Aleph and Tav divine, with the cloud. The house was filled with the cloud. And the court was full, Aleph and Tav divine, of the brightness of Yahuwah's glory. And the sound of the cherubim's wings, the sound of the cherubim's wings was heard even to the outer court, as the voice of El Shaddai when he speaks. And we know that to be thunder. Hallelujah. And as it came to pass that when he commanded the man clothed with linen, saying, take fire from between the ophanim, from between the cherubim, and he went in and stood beside the wheels, the UFOs that we call them UFOs. And one cherub stretched forth, Aleph and Tav divine, his hand from before between the cherubim into the fire that was between the cherubim, and took thereof, and put it in the hands of him that was clothed with linen, who took it and went out. And there appeared in the cherubim the form of a man's hand under their wings. And when I looked, behold, the four ophanim by the cherubim, one ophan by one cherub, and another ophan by another cherub. And the appearance of the ophanim was as the color of a beryl stone. These are red wheels. And as for their appearances, they four had one likeness, as if an ophan had been in the midst of an ophan, a wheel within a wheel. And what are we seeing right now? Wheels within wheels in our skies. Hallelujah. And when they went upon their four sides, and they turned not as they went. But to the place whither the head looked, they followed it, and they turned not as they went. And what is that referring to? It's referring to the fact that these ships, these cherubim and seraphim, these ophanim, they don't need to turn. Like when you're in a regular airplane, you have to maneuver to turn this way or that. And there's certain positions that you cannot turn into. There are certain moves that an airplane cannot make. These UFOs can do whatever they want. They defy all reason of normal earthly rules. Verse 11, chapter 10, Ezekiel. And when they went upon their four sides, and they turned not as they went. But to the place whither the head looked, they followed it, and they turned not as they went. And their whole body, and their backs, and their hands, and their wings, and the ophanim were full of eyes round about, even the ophanim that they four had. And as for the ophanim, it was cried unto them in my hearing, O wheel, O wheel. And every one had four faces. The first face was as the face of a cherub. The second face was as the face of a man. The third, the face of a lion. And the fourth, the face of an eagle. And the cherubim were lifted up. This is the living creature that I saw by the river of Kabar. And when the cherubim went, and the ophanim went by them, and when the cherubim lifted up, Aleph and Tav divine, their wings to mount up from the earth, the same ophanim also turned not from beside them. And when they stood, these stood, and when they were lifted up, these lifted themselves up also. For the spirit of the living creature was in them. And then the glory of Yahuwah departed from off the threshold of the house and stood over the cherubim. And the cherubim lifted up Alpha and Omega divine, their wings, and mounted up from the earth in my sight. And when they went out, the ophanim also were there beside them, and everyone stood at the door of the east gate of Yahuwah's house, and the glory of the Elohai of Israel was over them above. This is the living creature that I saw under the Elohai of Israel by the river of Kabar, and I knew that they were the cherubim. Everyone had four faces apiece, and everyone had four wings. And the likeness of the hands of a man was under their wings. And the likeness of their faces was the same faces which I saw by the river of Kabar, their appearances and themselves, and they went everyone straight forward. May the Most High bless you and keep you in the name of Jesus. Thank you for joining me. God bless you. Amen. Amen.